Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another PC port review. Today, we're looking at Minecraft Legends. Now, Minecraft Legends is developed by Mojang Studios and Blackbird Interactive. It is published by Xbox Games Studios. The description reads, "Discover the mysteries of Minecraft Legends, a new action strategy game. Explore a gentle land of rich resources and lush biomes on the brink of destruction. The ravaging piglins have arrived, and it's up to you to inspire your allies and lead them in strategic battles to save the overworld." Now, Minecraft Legends is $39.99 at the time of this recording. It is single player, online PvP, online co-op, cross-platform multiplayer, full controller support, but it does require a Microsoft account in order to play online and for crossplay. Now, I have done some testing, and unfortunately, this game does not work on the Steam Deck, no matter what I've tried. I've tried different layers of Proton, and in my opinion, the only way this game will actually work on the Steam Deck for right now is if you install Windows directly. Now, I do have a video on how to install Windows on an SD card for your Steam Deck, and you can play games that way. If you want to look at that, it's in the description down below or in the timestamp up here on the top right hand side. But I do have to say, though, right off the bat in the main menu, we're seeing some things that we normally don't see. The 7900 XT is at 62% usage, but we are getting 2,341 FPS in the main menu, which is something we don't normally see on this channel. I will say that. The VRAM allocated is 2.4 gigs. Dedicated is 511 megabytes. That's right, you heard that right. We are below a gig in dedicated VRAM. Now, the 7700X CPU is at 26% average, but there are some cores that are really pointing out at me as to being some concern. So core 3 specifically, core 13, 15, and 16, and about that, are all hitting anywhere between 20% to 77% usage, while everything else is just not being used at all. So I have a feeling this is going to be more CPU limited than other games, rather than GPU, even though there seems to be a lot more headroom on the GPU left, and we're getting about 2000 FPS. Hopefully, we would get about 4000 FPS if it wasn't CPU limited. So we're seeing a bit of a bottleneck there. In terms of RAM allocated, it's 9.7 gigs. Dedicated, it is 1.9 gigs. So, a couple of things, like I said, CPU seems to be the big factor for this game right now. So, you may have to be making some adjustments on that end. But, let's take a look at the actual settings menu. That is my Microsoft account, if you want to follow me on Xbox, even though I don't even play on Xbox, that's perfectly fine. Under accessibility options, there are swap AND buttons, swap X and Y buttons, wrap hotbar navigation, text-to-speech, which is fine. Text size, I kept at 100. For some reason, if you go to 150, it doesn't look right. I don't know if it's just aliased much better at 100%, but at 150, the text to me seems blurrier, strange enough. Skip cinematic, yes. Colorblind mode, if you need that, it is there, which is very nice to see. In terms of audio, we have all kinds of text language, which is really great to see. Voice language, subtitles, master volume, dialogue volume, music volume, cinematics, sound effects, and ambience, which is nice to see as well. So in the graphics settings, you've got full screen on and off. Yes, this is in fact not exclusive full screen. So my mouse is going off to other sides of the monitor. So be aware of that as well. For my boys, if you're trying to do multi-monitor usage. It does have V-Sync, brightness, contrast. We do, ladies and gentlemen, though, have a field of view slider, which is fantastic, and it has the degree of the field of view, which is even better to see. However, though, we have all this real estate on the right-hand side and literally no visual representation of what it has to do in the first place. Resolutions as well are listed here, and rendering level, ultra high, medium, and low, with no other descriptors, no other information, no other detail, no advanced settings, nothing along that nature, and no visual representation of what ultra, medium, high, or low actually is. And of course, no counter for VRAM being used, which of course, NVIDIA boys are having a hard time with that. Besides that, this is not a great options menu in terms of graphics. I would have liked to see a lot more detail. Even though this is a Minecraft game, that doesn't excuse the fact that a lot of people are going to be trying to playing this on either lower end hardware or anything along that nature. And having the ability to see what the game is going to look like as well as VRAM usage really is important, because a lot of people who in fact do play Minecraft are a lot smarter than you actually think. So having that information there is critical. Moving on. Now, when we go into the actual controller settings, we've got quite a few things. Camera, building placement, redstone launcher, X and Y axis, toggled mode for build view, sprint toggled mode, things like that. We also have the ability to rebind every single button on the controller, which is nice to see. I would have liked that to be there from the beginning. And also the fact that we are now using the entire right-hand side. We are here, except for we didn't use it for graphics, but we're using it for the controller. Riddle me that one, Batman. I don't know. Spawner interaction for spawner move and recall, redstone launcher, building view, all different kinds of setups that you want to make if you can. This is, in my opinion, the true accessibility option, because this is actually what people truly need in order to have the perfect experience for them to play. So this is great to see, that the fact that it's fully rebindable on a controller. However, I don't see that. Yes, here is for the keyboard and mouse. And you even have an icon for the entire keyboard there as well. So we had that here for the controller and the keyboard. We don't have it for graphics. Would have been nice to see. So besides that, options menu is subpar. It's not great. It's not bad. It could be better. I understand that it is a Minecraft game and is targeted for younger audiences. However, though, some of these younger audiences may not have, like I said, the type of PC needed to run this game and may need to be adjusting settings if necessary. So it would be nice to have more detail and fine tuning. So let's go ahead and jump into the campaign. I've already done the tutorial. Let's go ahead and see how it runs in game. It actually runs somewhat well, in fact. We are going to be shooting up and pinging the GPU at 99% usage when we get in game. We are sitting, though, at 3 gigs of VRAM allocated, 1.2 gigs dedicated. CPU usage has still stayed about the same with those specific cores and threads. So 16, 15, 13, 11, and now we're looking at 5 and 9, as well as 3 and 4, really jumping up there in the 30s to 40s. So again, this will be more of a CPU limited game rather than a GPU limited game from what I'm seeing here. But still, even though the GPU is being maxed out, we are getting 200 FPS. The frame time graph is basically a solid line, but I do think, though, on the offhand, you will have some CPU issues here and there if you're not cautious with that, because it seems to be pinging specific cores and threads. Just be cautious on that end, even though the GPU is actually flushed. So let's go ahead and mess around here. Let's jump around, because the game honestly does play rather well. I just want to test to see. Mouse movement feels fine. I don't feel any acceleration here as well. Sorry if that made you dizzy. But everything feels pretty good. Level of detail seems fine. The FOV slider has truly made a huge difference, honestly. And it's really nice to see that as well. But the game does run well. I'm actually quite impressed. We finally have a somewhat competent PC port. And I'm even happier that they're not including any Denuvo DRM, as Microsoft has liked to do that for some reason quite recently. So getting around 200 FPS isn't too bad. Let's have a quick test though and see what the GPU will be like if we knock it down to, let's say, 60 FPS. So I didn't lock it to 60, but what I did was I locked it to 144, which is the refresh rate of my monitor. As you can see though, we are sitting at around 66% GPU usage, but those CPU cores that we talked about earlier are still hitting quite high. So like I said, even though we were flushed before on the GPU and the CPU usage was the same, here we're seeing CPU usage being dropped quite a bit, and we are still seeing cores 15, 16, 11, 7, and 3 hit in the 40 to 50% range. So that does prove my point that if you have a CPU issue or you're seeing some stutters here and there or it's not running correctly, this could be a CPU bottleneck more than anything on this end. So just be aware of that as well. So not too bad. Let's see if I can actually get it to 60 though, like I said before. So now we've locked the game to 60 FPS and we are still seeing some CPU usage, like I said before, core 16, 15, 13, as well as 3 and 7 are still quite high. The frame time graph looks honestly fantastic. Let me adjust the 1% lows in 0.1, but it doesn't really matter in my opinion because we are still seeing some great frame rates and frame times. And even though we are locked at 60, GPU usage is at 52%. This game is very scalable. However, like I said, it may be more CPU dependent than what you might expect to what you're actually seeing here. So definitely just be cautious and be aware of that if you're getting that kind of thing. Now, I will say though, at 60 FPS, the mouse control does feel very strange. It does feel like there is some input latency though at 60 FPS, which is kind of odd. I didn't really see that at 144 or even at 200 FPS. So this feels like it's gonna be more of a controller game than a mouse and keyboard. So just be aware of that as well. But all in all, not a bad port, not a great port. Definitely far better than what we've seen normally on this channel. I'd give this a C, pretty solid, not too bad, not too great, pretty much on average. And it seems to be scalable quite well. Like I said, some CPUs might have an issue here and there. But anyways, that's going to be it for the PC port review. If you guys like this kind of content, please subscribe. If you want to see more of this, as well as gaming news, emulation, Steam Deck stuff, fanboy videos, and live streams, we are here as well, so we're getting close to 44,000 subs. It really does mean a lot. If you want to join the Discord, you can do that by becoming a YouTube member, a Patreon sub, or a Twitch sub. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you have a great one, and I'll see you next time.